I'm gonna rip this head off, and he knows it. What are you gonna do about it?
Disrespect.
What are you gonna do about it?
The rivalry between one strawweight MMA world champion Jared Brooks and Filipino phenom Joshua Pacio is among the most bitter in promotional history. And on March 1st, the two will clash once again to settle the score at 1-166 Qatar. Before their highly anticipated rematch, learn about the history of each competitor. In April 2019, Joshua Pacio recaptured the coveted one strawweight MMA world title. It cemented him as the world's best in his weight class. His reign was active, making title defense after title defense.
Is he about to tap out? He is! It's over!
Look at him piecing him up with that jab.
Oh, high kick to a spinning back fist to a left hand! What a combination from Pacio!
Nicely placed from Pacio.
Oh, the left hand! Stuns him in another one! And a third, a fourth, a fifth, a sixth, it's over!
The Filipino superstar seemed unbeatable.
Joshua Pacio, still the strawweight king.
But a new and brash challenger would soon emerge. In November 2021, American wrestling sensation Jared Brooks arrived at the world's largest martial arts organization, ONE Championship. His first test would come against Pacio's teammate Lito Adiwong, who was skeptical of the promotional newcomer.
Deep inside of him, he knows that he's in trouble.
I plan on giving him a good American butt whooping.
How would Brooks fare as he stepped onto the world's largest stage?
They're raring to go. You can feel the energy between these two dragons.
Big takedown.
This is not a good spot to be in against Jared Brooks.
Uppercut from the Thunder Kid, nicely done. He stuck him with it.
Drops down, attacks.
Oh, here, boom, shakalaka.
Steps over, Adiwan's gonna try to do something, but gives up an arm triangle in the process.
Catch.
Into the neck and arm of Lito Adiwan. Lito Adiwan.
He taps out, it's good night, Irene.
Brooks' top-tier wrestling and natural aggression were on full display with his dominant win. It was a warning shot to the strawweight MMA division at large, and more specifically, the reigning champion Joshua Pacio. Brooks continued to put the division on notice in his next bouts, showing why he's known as the Monkey God with ape-like strength and seemingly inhuman grappling ability.
Jared Brooks!
Aggression early on from Jared Brooks.
Bokang does a beautiful job of staying on his feet as Brooks jumps to the back.
Oh, have a look at that from Jared Brooks.
You can see Brooks triangle the legs to give him a little bit better grip. Brooks has got good back control.
Looping the knuckles around to hit the top of the head of Masignani.
He's a little bit close. He's close to it. This might be it.
Is this it? It's going to be Jared Brooks and Joshua Pacio.
All the while, he unabashedly made his world title aspirations clear.
Joshua Pacio, you better be ready, baby. The Monkey God is coming.
Brooks's confrontational nature did not sit well with Pacio.
I feel bad for Jared Brooks that he needs to do that. As a martial artist, kailangan mong ipakita yung core values ng martial artist.
Joshua Pacio, baby.
Who's coming? Who's coming, Joshua Pacio? Me.
With an undefeated record in ONE, Brooks was on a collision course with five-time ONE strawweight MMA world champion Joshua Pacio. Tension between the two continued to escalate as their world title fight approached at 1-164 in Manila.
Good luck to you. Make sure you cut that weight, fatty.
I've had a lot of people from the Philippines telling me to beat Josh's ass, and I'm ready to do it.
He wants to get in my head. That's not gonna happen.
Let's give it up for Jared Brooks, Joshua Pacio! They're ready to go right now. Security having to hold them back.
I'm gonna rip this head off on Saturday, and he knows it, and his whole team knows it. I'm gonna bring it right back to the United States. Let's go.
He always said, taking head off, that's my ancestors doing the mountains, and I'm gonna show you that tomorrow.
We gonna see.
Who would emerge as the strawweight MMA king at 1-164?
Clinton moving early on, right band!
There's a lot of movement coming, ooh.
We're on the floor early, ground and pound from Jared Brooks. Pacio tries to get to his feet, Brooks keeps him on the ground. Pacio hoping to choke him! Exactly where Jared Brooks wants to be, in Brooksville, in Brooksland. Lots of movement again. Spinning back fist from Pacio! Shaking his head, on the high kick!
Ooh.
turning back into the midsection. A Pacio specialty. Very fast with the striking.
Brooks is starting to bloody up the champ.
And now he's got him down and takes the back of Pacio. He wants to find a way to strangle the champion.
He's got 10 seconds. Can he survive?
And it's over. He gets the thumbs up. Brooks goes upstairs. Outside leg kick from Pacio. Sticks the jab, throws the hook.
No! Undisputed one strawweight champion of the world!
Jared Brooks walked away from the battle with gold in his hand. After a hard-fought war, he was gracious in victory.
First thing I want to say is most respect to Joshua Pacio and Team Lakay. I love the Filipino people. This right here, Dad, this is for you, man.
Pacio went on to leave the famed Team Lakay and looked to develop his skill set with former teammates at the newly formed Lions Nation MMA. Then at One Fight Night 15, the Passion earned an impressive victory over fellow contender and dangerous wrestler, Mansoor Malachiev. The rematch between Jared Brooks and Joshua Pacio is now set for the biggest combat sports event in Qatar history, One 166 Qatar.
I don't want to beat him by unanimous decision. I want to prove to Shatri. I want to prove to all of One Championship. I want to prove to the Philippines. I want to prove to the whole world that I am the true world champion. And then after that, I want to beat the GOAT.
Nakakapag-motivate sa akin talaga is to get that belt. I will definitely look for a finish.
Who will write the next winning chapter in this storied MMA rivalry? Find out at One 166 Qatar, live on March 1st.